Jason for a long time has played live on Stars End a few times, and has actually done a donor concert for us here in this room. That was like a special premium for listeners and donors. And he's also a teacher, and he teaches art and other aspects of art in Maryland at Mika. And his sound, gosh, when he first came to play on the show, his music was really smooth, you know, like kind of not drones, but just kind of this sustaining atmosphere throughout. And over the years, his music has, well, as anyone's should, it's changed a little bit. Some aspects of it are like that, but he's incorporated like a lot of new and different influences in. Here's one of them right here. It's a radio, a scanner. And so anyway, his music is also a lot different than Mike's. It's more dynamic. It has parts, more parts. It doesn't just, sometimes it's more active.
It's better.
It doesn't, like Mike's kind of wash one into the next section, and Jason's does that sometimes, but also, you know, he might play us his hit single or something like that. So, but he also has like a more elaborate setup, and he has a laptop, he's got some outboard gear. I don't think he has an actual synthesizer, like a hardware synthesizer, but he's got a synthesizer, I think, on his iPad. But, well, before I just say, like, well, I don't want you to list everything you're using, but because you have a computer, I wonder, is anything pre-recorded in this, or how do you explain how your set happened?
Sure. Actually, what you'll be hearing tonight is all new music. I'm working on a new album. It's really funny that you predicated the entire evening with talking about trying new music out on the audience. And that's what you guys are going to be subjected to this evening. A lot of what you're going to be hearing tonight are live variations of songs I'm considering for an upcoming record. Probably 30% of what you'll be hearing is pre-recorded, just because the music is so complex, and with a lot of electronic music, oftentimes that's the nature of the music. What you'll be hearing is the rhythmatic and some of the sequencers and stuff like that are, I don't want to say pre-recorded, but already preset. And then there's a lot of 70% improvisation over top of it. You know, I kind of know and have an idea of what the compositions are going to be sonically in my head, but oftentimes what I like about live presentation is that it can really, depending on the dynamic of the space and the reception of the audience, the receptiveness of the audience, it can really just completely take a whole different twist, and that informs the decisions that I make ultimately when I'm putting together a record. Too, there may be things that happen in the live scenario that I, which oftentimes do, that are completely unanticipated, and that I really, really like quite a bit. And those then in the studio find themselves, weaving their way into the sort of sonic tapestry, to not sound cheesy, but into the fabric of the experience. And that's what I really love about doing live performances. So that's more of an elaborate answer, but.
That's deep, yeah. So Jason's set is going to be about 45 minutes or so, maybe 50 minutes, and then we'll have an intermission. And think about what he said, because like a lot of, he's using software and some things are pre-recorded and predetermined. The music's going to be a lot different. It's going to be a lot more active than what Mike was doing, which was, just like a bare bones kind of set. So. Let's welcome Jason Sloan.
Thank you. Thank you. I can't do that. Seat round two, seat Monday night. Southwest winds 5 to 10 knots.
Question for Jason, or a comment, or anything?
When's the CD coming out?
What's the iPad doing?
I have a couple of different synthesizers. Primarily, I was using it's a software version of the Korg MS-20, which is on there, which I have a lot of different sequences and stuff I created. The last sequence, actually, that was in the final, the closing track, was created on that software. And I was using a number of different custom pads and patches and stuff that I had done. This is the first performance, actually, I decided to try to bring the iPad out of the studio into a live scenario, and it's a really awesome tool because you can actually, you know, initially when it was just the screen, it kind of sucks to try to, you know, I'm very tactile, you know, when you've got this touchpad, you can't play chords or anything. But Akai had come out with a small micro keyboard, which with the camera kit, you can just plug right into the dock of it, and it sends sends and receives MIDI signals. And there's a number of different software synthesizers now that sound pretty freaking good for really cheap. That you can actually now tactically control. Korg actually had for a while created an actual hardware interface that looked exactly like the MS-20 that you could actually patch with that.
Miniature version.
Yeah, I mean, it was crazy. I mean, it's just a big MIDI controller, you know, so it's just, there's nothing in it. It's just sending and interfacing signals with it, but I mean, it's pretty sick looking. You know, it's like, whoa, you know, you have the iPad on top, so you got like this, the big analog, you know, replica, and you got the song, you know, so it's just kind of nerdy, but kind of.
The MS-20, what he's talking about is an older synthesizer that they don't make anymore, and he doesn't really have any physical synthesizers, but in the older days, you know, we used to have to rent a truck and put out, you know, all these, because each synthesizer made one note, you just like it was monophonic, and so you needed a lot of them to get a full sound. And so as, you know, what happens, you know, people get nostalgic or whatever, there's some people look back to like, oh, the old days when we had those old synthesizers. So many of them you can get in software form, and Jason has one here on his iPad.
And they don't, you know, honestly, it's like they don't, if you've ever played any of those actual, you know, analog systems, there's nothing that compares to that sound.
Yeah.
You know, I mean, it just like shakes your balls, and you're just like, oh.
Yeah, because the, all those newer synthesizers that are models of the older ones, and they don't. There's always some sonic quality that's lacking. If you've ever seen those older Moog synthesizers that are real big, that old pictures of old Tangerine Dream or Keith Emerson is a famous one for playing the old Moog. They have a really amazing sound to them, and it's. I've given this some thought. I think it's not any one thing. You know, it's not like, oh well, if we just got a Moog filter, or if we just got a Moog voltage controlled amplifier or an oscillator or whatever. It's all these things together, all these weird little variances and distortions in each little component that make it what it is, and it's hard to replicate that because it's just happened back then because that's where the technology was. It's hard to have all that represented in newer synthesizers. Mm-hmm. Are there any other anyone else want to say anything to Jason or any questions or comments?
I like your dance moves.
I told you.
I always tell my students, I'm like, we always talk about in live performance, I'm always like, you know, it's just, there's always the dudes that look like they're checking email. I've been guilty of that, you know, behind the laptop. And that I feel it, man. I'm just like, all right, I got to, you know, and I don't care. For a while, I was really self-conscious. I was like,
no, it's awesome.
But I don't care, man. And I'm just like, I'm feeling it, I'm excited, and I get all fired up. So.
Well, everybody's dipping, have a good time playing. Really let us know you are. Jason has some CDs for sale if you want to. Stop up and say hello to them and get one, or just ask some questions or chat or whatever. I think we should have an intermission here. It'll probably be about 20 minutes because we're going to switch over the set, the stage, or whatever this area is here for the next group, which is the Tangent Project. So once again, thank you very much.
Thank you.